Good morning, dear students. Welcome to Narayana online classes. For class 9 students, today's topic is nomenclature of polyfunctional groups. Few examples we will discuss about nomenclature of polyfunctional groups. In the given organic compound, more than one functional group is present. Then how to write the name of the organic compound? Okay. Now here, if you see the first example, now the given organic compound is like this: CH3, CHOH, CH2, CCH3. CH, CH3, CH2, COOH is there. Okay. Now according to the priority order, the first priority we have to give for COOH group, carboxylic acid group we have to give. Means I have to give the numbering from right to left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are. Okay. Means the root word is 6 carbon atoms are. Root word is the 6 carbon atoms, right? Now here root word, if it is 6 carbon atoms, then it is called as, here it is called as hex. Okay, and the nature of the compound, it is A, all are single bonds only. Then I can take as it is hexane. Now in first position COOH group is there, then it is called as secondary suffix is OH acid. Then it is taken as hexanoic acid, first position only to mention. Right, now then if you come to the suffixes, if you come to the substitutions, in third position methyl group is there, and fifth position hydroxy group is there. Then 5 hydroxy 3 methyl. According to the alphabetical order, if you write, hydroxy will come first. Okay, then methyl group will come. Then what is the name of the organic compound? It is 5 hydroxy 3 methyl hexanoic acid. Hexanoic acid. That is the name of the organic compound. For example, in this compound only, suppose small change is there. Okay. Suppose here double bond is present. Here C double bond is there. Then what is the name of the organic compound? Root word is not changed. Right? And groups also have not changed. Suppose otherwise, in the place of OH here, I am taking as a halogen like chlorine I have taken. Then what is the name of the organic compound? Now, I can take as numbering is same, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. Hex is fixed here, root word is same. OH acid also fixed here. Extra what came now? In the place of OH, Cl is there. Between second carbon atom and third carbon atom, there is a double bond is there. Means what is the nature of the compound? It is ene. Ene means it is double bond, unsaturated compound is there. Then here I can take as it is hex. Which position there is a double bond? Second position, hex 2 in. Okay, hex 2 in, one OH acid I can take. One OH acid. Then, what are the substitutions? 3 methyl is same. But here, in 5th position, chlorine is there. Now, Cl, chlorine, according to the alphabetical order, Cl will come first or methyl will come first, chlorine will come first. C, A, B, C, no? Then I can take the name of the compound is what? Now the name of the organic compound is, I can write as 5-chloro-3-methyl hex-2-in-1-OH acid. Hex-2-in-1-OH acid. Means unsaturation is nothing but what it is? It is primary suffix it is. Okay. Primary suffix is there. Like that you can write the name of the organic compound. Now come to the third example. Third example now here I am taking as here aldehyde group is there as a suffix here. Okay. Aldehyde group is there as a suffix. Primary suffix is primary suffix all nature is what? Primary suffix is single bonds only now. Right? Now secondary suffix is what here? Secondary suffix is aldehyde. Now CH means what we will call it is Al. Al, aldehyde. Now numbering you start from right to left once again. According to the priority order, first priority we have to give for aldehyde, not for NO2 or not for chlorine, not for bromine. And halogens are not treated as functional groups. Okay, now anyway, now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 I am taking. Now root word once again 6 it is, hex. Then here I can take as hexanoic, hexanol it is, hexanol. Okay, and if you come to the substitutions, bromine will come first now. In which position? Which position bromine is there? Fourth position bromine is there. Then I can write as 4-bromo
4 chloro, then 2 nitro, hexanal, NaL.
Hexane 1-al or hexanal we can write. Okay, that is the name of the organic compound, right? Like that we can write. Now come to the fourth example. Now what is the nomenclature of the given organic compound? Now once again COOH is there here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now 5 carbons are the root word. 5 carbons, what we can call it is pentanoic acid. Then hydroxy means 4 hydroxy it is. Hydroxy is the secondary prefix here. 3 nitro, 2 chloro. Okay, now if you arrange according to the alphabetical order, then first what will come? 2 chloro will come. 2 chloro, then hydroxy, H no, after H N will come. Then 2 chloro, 4 hydroxy, 4 hydroxy, 3 nitro, pentanoic acid. Okay, 2 chloro, 4 hydroxy, 3 nitro, pentanoic acid. Here what you have to remember while writing the nomenclature, whatever the substitutions are there, substitutions are you have to arrange according to the alphabetical order. We should not consider if more than one like tri, di, tetra, if it is there, we should not consider those as alphabetical order. Remaining part we have to consider. Like that, we can write the nomenclature of the organic compounds. Okay, thank you.